broken. You can give him, raise your hand. He's still having that.
Oh, there he is. He's coming down now.
Okay, just remember that, okay?
Yeah.
When he grabs it, don't hold back. Right. If you try holding back, he gets mad. Yeah, just like that. Way up. Raise your hand.
All right. Watch.
All right.
I was angry about that one.
Where's the shriek at?
Was that good?
Yeah
he's booting us here.
Mosquitoes in 1 hour.
They're like a part of the tree. Yeah, yes. I did a couple of those for my house.
And I can assure you that
saw his wing move or whatever.
Yeah, they are not made in China. Nowadays, everything is made in China, right?
Yeah, pretty much. Yeah.
Not these guys.
But these ones? No, no, they are made in Belize.
Whatever, darn. Ah.
So they're just hanging out waiting to see mosquitoes?
No, they're sleeping.
Oh, they're sleeping
nocturnal.
Still.
Yeah.
During the day, they sleep.
Yeah.
What they do at night? They eat mosquitoes.
There we are.
Snake cactus.
Snake cactus.
Yeah,
it looks like a snake, right?
Yeah.
Snake cactus.
Herons in the tree.
Oh, herons.
Great blue. That's a both male and night heron.
Oh yeah, now I see it. Yes, I do.
Oh, both male.
I wasn't looking far enough for them.
They are nocturnal.
That won't be able to get.
And they feed on anything that can move in the water. That they can swallow, they would swallow it. So that she would lay 3 to 4 eggs in that nest, and her job is finished. The male bird would have to incubate the egg, take care of the chick, while the female does the same with 6 other male birds. So what kind of bird would you call this?
A lucky bird.
A lucky female bird.
Yeah.
Because you can see how you're gonna fall. You're gonna drop right now.
Later on, the Royal Ontario Museum of Canada heard about this site. They are the one that sent on Dr. David Pendergast, the archaeologist that did some work here from 1974 to 1986. Priests. Whenever the peasant would plant the crops, they used to bring a special offering for the high priest to go up there and do special ceremonies. Mm-hmm. And in a few more days, you see rain. So they thought that that was what causes the rain to come down.
Here we are, it's Tuesday, we're about an hour outside of Belize City, and we just arrived at the beginning of our ziplining and cave tubing adventure. We're with a bunch of people from cruise ships, and most people are going right to cave tubing. We're going to do some ziplining first and then do the cave tubing. Hi, Christina.
Yeah.
Wave.
I'm looking at my camera.
Oh.
Yeah. Thank you for choosing my country.
Yes.
I'm happy you did. To spend a few days with us here and enjoy some of Belize's beautiful nature. Ready?
Uh-huh.
Sit down, pick your feet up. Keep it loose. Keep it very loose. Keep it loose. Keep it loose. There you go.
Here comes Robert on his first zip line. Coming in, coming in.
Come on.
Okay, sit down.
Okay.
Stick your feet up. Lean all the way back. Lean back. There you
okay.
go. Keep it loose.
Yep, loose.
There you go.
You gotta back just a little bit.
Come on, come on, come on.
Yay!
We're going to the longest and fastest zip line right now.
This is where you want to videotape.
This is it.
If you notice, there's some cuts, there's some marks there that the locals did. They would go into the jungle during the harshest time, which would be during the rainy season, where there's a lot of bugs, a lot of botflies, leishmaniasis, malaria, dengue, and the list goes on. But what they would do is they would prefer when it's raining, because they would put a big container down and they would collect the sap. See the cuts? And what they would do is they would collect the sap, process it to a fire, and then they would spread it, let it cool off, and then we'd make small blocks. 5-10 pounds, and then it would export it to Wrigley's. Wrigley's would then add flavor to it, making the chiclets, the chewing gum. So at the time, this is where the chewing gum came from.
Yeah, out there. Yeah. Special.
All kinds of wildlife, and it was, yeah, it was amazing. And then climbing on to the top of the temple was a lot of fun. Yeah.
You have some very, very sharp claws. You can be very bad.
Yeah.
Nice. A family of Quadimundis.
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 Lots of them.
Yeah.
In Belize, there are 138 different species of mammals, but most of them consist of bats. From there's now over 70 different species of bats, from
food
bats, insect bats, fishing bats, and a few exception of vampire bats. Yes.
How was the ziplining?
Double thumbs up.
Yes. Wave, Christina.
Hi.
Hello.
You look wonderful. Not at all.
I'm here. No turning back. No one scared?
No.
Whoa. How about now? No one scared?
Nope.
Yeah, and I give up. You guys too hard to scare. Takes a lot of practice. Here's I say. All right, there you go.
I like the photo pose. There.
Okay, guys, boat's up. Don't eat this tree, that tree. Might just eat the wrong tree. Messing with Speedy, might just eat the wrong tree. I only know about some, not all of them, you know. I'm more of a city guy. Then the palms that you're seeing are called Cujun palms. One of the longest palms in the Belize rainforest is known to grow up to 40 to 50 feet in length.
Wow.
The Mayans, they would collect them, make their tattoos for their homes, Mayan shingles. Known to last up to 20 years before needing to be changed.
Oh,
and
wow.
It produces
long.
A little nut called the Cujun nut. A little miniature coconut. And they make Cujun cooking oil from those. There you go. Then we have another culture called the mestizo, like Yoni, my boss, remember this morning on the bus?
Mm-hmm.
He's mestizo. Christopher Columbus sailed over here, met the Mayan chief's daughter, bam, Yoni. That's how it happened. That's how it happened.
Thank you. Senegal. 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 Senegal.
This is the Belize that everybody talks about. Don't go to Belize! Because it's dangerous!
Yeah.
Of hours from leaving for the island. Right now we're having lunch at the Saffron restaurant right on the water. Our food just came. We're having the Takari chicken with rice and beans. And we have nice weather, but a little rainstorm just passed over. We are taking a little plane to the island.
Opa would be proud. Anyway, we're here. It's amazing. This is our little cabana.
Number three.
Number three. And we just had a little intro at the bar with a free drink with our hosts, Sandy and JW. They're from Texas. And we have a bunch of dives that we're going to do. I might get my advanced certification. And I'm a little bit speechless right now because it's so awesome here. You can see all around. This is just like
snorkelers coming back from their day trip.
Yeah, this is very much like a paradise. You can just pan around and show the viewers at home what we have.
The lagoon with crocodiles is there.
And we were expecting every cabana to be filled with another group, but they didn't make it. So right now it's just us.
Yeah, as far as scuba diving.
Right.
The rest is snorkelers. So we got private lessons coming up, which is pretty sweet.
And when we don't
And we
like...
even have our own little palm tree. That's palm tree! With coconuts!
And when we don't feel like going in the ocean or kayaking, we have our own infinity pool a little further away.
Yes.
And we can do that at night or whenever we want, so...
Because there's no swimming in the water at night, because there's crocodiles!
That's right. So...
Which we saw on... the new river earlier in the week.
Yes. Anyway, so this is our first day and we are looking forward to the next week.
Yay!
We're in the dining room having our first dinner of shrimp. What kind of shrimp is it? Shrimp and... I forgot what kind of shrimp, but really good shrimp. And there's a snorkeling group here and some of them are also eating dinner. And this is the dining room where we're going to be having our meals three times a day. It is our second night here at the resort after our first full day of diving, and it was an amazing day of diving. Didn't do a lot of video or pictures. Anyway, we are getting ready for bed, and it's been kind of cloudy and a little rainy today, but not so bad. But right now, as we got out of dinner, we have this really ugly storm that's moved through. I don't know if you can hear it. The rain's really coming down and it's pretty windy. This is looking out from our front door and looking back towards our hut, our cabana, which is staying pretty nice and toasty. There's Christina. Staying pretty nice and toasty, except for a few spots in our thatched roof. We have a couple of leaks and a little piece of thatching that has come loose, kind of hard to see. A couple of wet spots on the ground, but otherwise pretty nice in here. We have the ceiling fan turned off tonight, the windows closed, and hopefully we'll get a good night's rest for another amazing day of diving tomorrow.
Yeah. You're gonna spearfish?
Yeah, once you start, you can't go back.
Cold-blooded.
Christina just out of the water.
Yeah, you got the prosperity.
Now I get why it's kind of not to swim to the boat.
Like, I don't know what you want to do.
See, divers still in the water.
The imprint in the sandy bottom.
Yeah, you
look like something is fresh when you're flying.
That's all it is,
yeah.
Two anniversaries. Gosh, that's amazing. Wow. I guess he doesn't like tortillas. On a rainy Tuesday morning, waiting to go to Blue Hole for the day.
I'm familiar with the boating thing, and I've just learned to be open.
Keep your stomach full.
Yep, keep me. You're not new.
Here we are at the Blue Hole. Just did our Blue Hole dive, went down to 130 feet, saw a shark. Water was a little cold and a little murky, but it was a really good dive. We have a Blue Hole in the sky as well as in the ocean. Now we're gonna go down to Half Moon Caye, and do a really nice dive. There's Polly trying to get out of the hi there's Polly. Here we are topside of Big Bird, just swimming away from the Blue Hole. I guess you can't really see it, but back over there. This is Leo, our captain. Heading over to Half Moon Caye.
See, I told you guys, by the end of the week, you guys gonna end up with me.
That's right. Spouts off in the distance. We're just about to start our Half Moon Caye dive. Here we are at Half Moon Caye after our second dive. Gonna have some barbecue for lunch now and then head out for our third and final dive.
Area here.
Look at, there's the babies. You can see into that nest. Look at the babies. See it? The little fuzzy things. Oh, the baby. Good spot. Good spot. Oh, it's the cutest thing ever.
Right footed.
There's another little baby. Oh, look at, there's one just right there. Oh, that's what she's looking at.
Look at the baby.
Yeah, the whole family's looking too.
Seattle followed us. It's pouring. Time to get underwater.
It's Wednesday morning. We just had breakfast and we are getting ready to leave. In about 10 minutes, we have to board the boat to go back to the mainland. And that's going to bring the end to an awesome week of diving and hanging out here at the Blackbird Caye. And we're really sad to leave, and I don't want to leave. Christina's getting ready. This is our last moment in our hut. And the weather's pretty icky outside. But we're still sad to go. We are back at the Dinest Inn in Belize City, and it's raining here just as it was on the island. Tonight's our last night. We fly back tomorrow.
Tomorrow.
We wish we were both still on the island, but oh well. Saying goodbye to Belize.
Bye bye.
our last shot of Belize, buildings at the airport.
Back in Seattle, it's 8:30.
Can't get closer.
And taking out the jacket.
The puffy jacket.
This is the official end to the vacation.
Puffy jacket.
Because I'm putting on the down jacket.
Puffy jacket, boo.
Thus, Belize vacation comes.